Good afternoon, students. Today we are going to take your the paper discussion of class test. Okay, so here the chapter which has been included in this class test was the neural control and coordination. I hope your paper was easy. Okay, so we are going to check one by one questions. Okay, and let us know the correct option for those questions. Okay, and if you feel any difficulty or if you feel any kind of doubt regarding any of the questions, okay, you can text me on the WhatsApp. I'll clear it. Okay, so let's start with the first question, that is the question number 91. So the question is, which part of the brain controls intellectual ability? Okay, and the options are frontal lobe, parietal lobe, temporal lobe and occipital lobe. Okay, so the correct option for this question is the parietal lobe. Okay, as we can see, there is a association area which is found in the cerebrum, okay, of the what we say parietal lobe. Okay, and that association area is associated with the communication, intellectual activities. Fine. The next question number 92, olfactory area is present in. Okay, so the options are given: frontal lobe, parietal lobe, temporal lobe and occipital lobe. So basically temporal lobe, okay, if we look after the structure of brain like this, okay, so here you have the your cerebellum, right? Now certain areas we have discussed already within the cerebrum, the part of the cerebrum, okay, that we have seen there are certain structures which are associated with regulation of various different types of functions of the body. Okay, this is like this, isn't it? So this area, it consists of the general motor area. Here the premotor area is there, right? Premotor, it is the motor. Okay, this part is the association area. Okay, this part is the somatostatic area. Okay, then next to that there will be the occipital part, okay, occipital region here. Right, occipital part. Here is the this association area basically, okay. So this association area has the parietal lobe or the parietal. Okay, here we have the frontal one, frontal lobe, and in this region we also have the gustatory area, then next to that is the auditory area. Okay, and here we have the Broca area, then next to that there is a presence of the olfactory area. Olfactory area. Okay, and this location is approximately near to the temporal lobe. Temporal lobe. Okay, so it is present near the temporal lobe. See, the options are given. Question was the olfactory area is present in frontal lobe, parietal lobe, temporal as well as the occipital. So the correct option will be the temporal lobe, okay, for the question number 92. The next question number 93, in brain the region of perception of pain is located in. Okay, so here this part, this is the region that is the been comprises within the occipital, that is the next to the parietal region, that is somatostatic area. and somesthetic area, it is associated with the pain, touch, okay, and temperature, like sensations. So this is a physical sensation which has been sensed by the occipital area. So here the options are frontal lobe, parietal lobe, occipital lobe and temporal lobe, okay. The next, somesthetic or post central central area is responsible for, okay. So see, the options are given: initiation of motor impulses for voluntary muscles, okay, initiation of motor impulses for involuntary muscles, then perception of pain, touch and temperature, and coordination of speech. So see, basically somesthetic area, it is for touch, pain and temperature. So option C will be correct for it. In the, I think whatever answer key it is given, in that answer key the option A will be given, but that is not correct. The answer is about the touch, pain and temperature, okay. So option C is correct for question number 94, okay. The next, question number 95, Broca area is connected with. Now Broca means what? It is associated with the speech. So here you can see the Broca area is there in the brain or in the cerebrum, that is referred with the speech area. So see, yes, option 1, that is correct for this, okay. So basically option D is given in the answer key, that is also not correct. Just look after that, certain corrections we have to make it, okay. So option A is the correct answer, that is for question number 95, okay. Then question number 96, look after the question, that is the primary visual area is located in, okay. So visual area is located over here, okay, and that is in the occipital part. So option C will be correct for this. Occipital part consists of the visual area. Visual area. Okay. Then next, question number 97. That is the yes. For question number 96, option C was the correct. And question number 97, the hippocampus converts information from option A, that is the short-term memory, to the long-term memory, okay. That is the function of the hippocampus, okay. As well as it is also responsible for aggression, okay, to remember the fear. So both the options can be seen here, that is A as well as C, okay, for question number 97. The next, question number 98, feeling of anger, pain, rage are experienced through, it is through the limbic system. As we know, in the limbic system two systems are there, amygdala and the hippocampal area, right. These are responsible for regulation of this rage, pain, anger, okay. So that is the example of the limbic system, okay. The next, anterior choroid plexus is found in the roof of, it is found in the roof of the iter, okay, option A. The next, question number 100, that is crura cerebri are found in, these are found in the forebrain, okay. These are found in the forebrain. So these are the this is the answer of question number 100. The next, question number 101, vermis is a part of, okay. So vermis is a part of, guys, it is a part of cerebellum, okay. That is option C. The next, Purkinje cells are found in, okay. So Purkinje cells are found in the cerebral cortex, okay. Purkinje cells, see, Purkinje fibers, you might be studied in the heart or the wall of the heart. That is, these Purkinje fibers, they are supposed to stimulate the wall of the heart for contraction, okay, during the contraction and relaxation. That is, the pumping function of the heart is been regulated by the Purkinje fibers, fine. But here the Purkinje cells, they are found in the cerebral cortex, okay. The next, ventricle of brain are lined by the cells called, okay. So these are called the neuron cells, okay. These are called the neuron cells, okay. The next, arbor vitae is a part of, okay, arbor vitae is a part of cerebrum, fine. The next, in the brain of mammals, the genu, that is genu, and splenium is are associated with. These are also associated with the cerebrum. Okay, so these are that is the question number 105. Next, 106. In the human brain, central sulcus is found between. Okay, so you can see in the human brain, central sulcus is found between the frontal and parietal lobe. Okay, frontal and parietal lobe. So this is the answer for 106. That is option number A. The next question number 107. Look after the question number 107. What it is given is the cavity in the region of diencephalon. Okay, diencephalon means, see, it is a third part of the forebrain, isn't it? Forebrain has three parts: olfactory lobes, cerebrum, and diencephalon, which comprises thalamus and hypothalamus. So here, diencephalon in the brain, the cavity in the region of diencephalon in the brain is called as the lateral ventricle. Okay, it is called as a lateral ventricle. The next, hypothalamus forms the floor of, hypothalamus forms the floor of fourth ventricle. Okay, the next, 109, voluntary muscular coordination is under the control of. So basically it is under the control of, it should be the cerebral hemisphere. Okay, because when we look after the voluntary, see this region, the motor region, okay, it is supposed to regulate the voluntary activity. Voluntary and premotor is for involuntary. But apart from involuntary, again hypothalamus region is there, which is supposed to regulate the involuntary activities. Many involuntary activities are there, which may include the thirst, which may include the what we say, sleep, okay, hunger, aggression, okay, then many are there, like sexual desire is there, one of the examples. So such type of involuntary activities are under the control of hypothalamus, okay, and some of under the premotor area. So here motor area is associated with the voluntary activities. Okay, so here the answer for the 109 should be the cerebral hemisphere, that is voluntary muscular coordination is under the control of. Okay, the next, memory weakens if one of the following part is injured. So yes, of course, memory, it is been means it will be weakened if the cerebellum part is been injured. Okay, so option C is correct for 110. The next, 111, a person feels no sensation when he puts his hand over the flame. Okay, the part of the brain which has damaged is, it is cerebrum. As we know, within the cerebrum there is a somesthetic area. If that part is been damaged, then there will be no sensation of the pain or not even temperature. Okay, so whatever physical sensations are there, these are being sensed by the somesthetic area. I hope you are getting this. Okay, the next, that is 112, the major relay station for sensory input that projects the cerebral cortex is. Okay, so relay station, basically it is the major relay center, it is the thalamus. Okay, so it is also referred as gatekeeper. So it is thalamus, option B for 112. Okay, sometime you may also get the answer as a hypothalamus also. Okay, so don't get confused within this. Thalamus will be the relay center. Okay, the next, yes, hypothalamus does not control. Options are sexual behavior, okay, option B, osmoregulation, hunger and satiety, okay, and creative thinking and consciousness. Okay, so basically hypothalamus, it is associated with involuntary activities, right? And osmoregulation, okay, it is a thermo, it comes under the maintenance of salt and water balance. So basically it comes under this question, means that is hypothalamus does not control the osmoregulation. Okay, otherwise it controls the sexual, means it controls the involuntary activity, like sexual behavior is there, hunger and anxiety is there, okay, creative thinking and consciousness is also a type of involuntary one. The next, which part of the brain is involved in the loss of control when a person drinks alcohol? Okay, so it's cerebellum, okay, which is responsible for loss of control when the person drinks alcohol. Okay, that is the option number D for question number 114. The next question number 115, which of the following is mismatched? Okay, so here some matches are given. We have to figure out which one is the mismatch. So here matches are like cerebrum for memory, olfactory lobes for smell, of course, then cerebellum for equilibrium of the body, medulla oblongata for temperature regulation. Okay, so it's cerebellum, okay, which is given is a mismatched. Okay, so this is the correct for question number 115. 116, all the unconscious activities like heartbeat, involuntary breathing and gut peristalsis are controlled by, okay, these are controlled by the cerebrum and medulla. Okay, so that is the option B. The next, the spinal cord in man extends from, okay, it extends from the level of third cervical vertebra to the coccyx. Okay, that is the spinal cord. The next, in spinal cord, white matter is, now see options are given here, surrounded by the gray matter, okay, mixed with the gray matter, okay, and around the gray matter and absent. So here basically, if you look after the structurally we can find out, okay, suppose I'm drawing here, is it visible? I think so in such a way we can see there will be presence of the gray matter and the white matter. So internally this part is referred as the gray matter, okay, that is the, if we look after the transverse section of the spinal cord, okay, this part will be referred as the gray matter basically, okay. And around the gray matter there is a white matter, this portion is of the white matter, okay. So that is what the description will be for the question, that is in the spinal cord white matter is around the gray matter, that is option number C. Okay, so certain corrections are there that to be made within the answer key. Okay, so in the answer key the option will be given D, that it is absent. No, basically it is around the gray matter. Fine. The next 119, which is the part of spinal cord? So the options are given ventricle, vertebral canal, ventral canal, central canal. So here spinal cord, we know that it comprises the vertebral column. So there is a central part is there, which is referred as vertebral canal, which is composed of cuboidal epithelial tissue. Okay, so the correct answer is for this 119 is the option number B, that is vertebral canal. Okay, in question number 120, the hollow interior of the cerebrum is called, it is the fourth ventricle. Okay, that is option B. The next, photopic vision is associated with, options are rods, cones, both of these, option D, vitreous humor. So it is associated with the cones, okay, that is photopic. And the another type of vision, that is the twilight vision, is been associated with the scotopic, okay, or that is the scotopic vision we call, that is with the help of the rods. Okay, so here the eye, option B will be the correct for 121. 122, the eyes of cat and dog shine, reflect back the light focused on them because, okay, the choroid is provided with tapetum and lucidum. Okay, so, and as well as here option can be the retina has, okay, only rods, no cones. So basically they may have the cones but they are not well developed. Okay, so in this condition both the options can be was incorrect. That is option C as well as D. Okay. So if anyone have solved the C, then it is also correct, and anyone have solved the D, then it is also correct. Okay, because option is not given like both, right? So both the options can be correct over here. That is 122. The next 123, the image formed on the eye retina is inverted and virtual. Okay, inverted and virtual. So here option D is correct. Then next 124. That is hypermetropia, that is long sight, is a condition in a human eye in which the image is formed. See, the answer is option D, in front of the retina, and can be corrected by using convex lenses. Okay, so option D is correct for the question number 124. 125, if eyeball is shorter, then probable defect would be, okay, that is the press option A, okay, presbyopia. Okay, that is the answer of 125. 126, lenses used by those who cannot see near objects. Okay, so option D is the answer, any of the above. Okay, then 127, inner irregular cornea result in, that is the strabismus. Okay, option C. The next, astigmatism. Okay, astigmatism can be corrected by using cylindrical lenses. Option D. Then 129, opacity of the lens in the eye leads to, okay, again presbyopia. Okay, option C. The next, in the following abnormality of the eye, which one is a serious condition that lead to blindness? That is the myopia. Okay, option A is correct for that. 131, glaucoma is due to increased intravesical pressure. That is option C for 131. 132, glaucoma can be caused by option D, blockage of canal of Schelm. Okay, that is option D. 133, helicoterma or helicotrema is located at, okay, near fenestra ovalis. That is option D. Then the waxy substance which coats the surface of auditory canal is produced by, okay, that is called meibomian glands. Okay, that is the answer for 134. Option C. 135, again, which of the following connects lateral ventricle or the paracel in the brain with third ventricle? It is foramen of Monroe. Okay, that is the option C, which is correct for question number 135. Then next, 136, clusters of neuron cell bodies within peripheral nervous system are, these are clusters of nerve or the neurons, means that is it is called ganglion. Okay, so option B is correct for that. Then 137, the correct sequence of meninges from inner to outside. Now we know that meninges is a protective covering which is present around the cerebrum, right? It is around the brain. So that consists of innermost pia mater, middle arachnoid, and outermost the dura mater. So it is asked inner to outside. Okay, so innermost most is the pia, middle is the arachnoid, and finally dura mater. So option C will be correct over here. See, option A is given in the answer key, that is not correct. A. So here option C is the correct, from inner to outside. Okay, we have also discussed during our lectures through the diagrammatic section. The next, subdural space is found between, okay, it is found subdural space is found between the arachnoid matter and the dura mater. Again, option C is correct over here. Okay, subdural space. The next, yes, cerebrospinal fluid is present in. See here, cerebrospinal fluid, okay, it is been released by the choroid plexus, or it has been secreted by the choroid plexus. Okay, so here basically it is present between two spaces, that is the subdural space also arachnoid space also. Means the space between the pia mater and arachnoid mater is called as the subarachnoid mater, subarachnoid space, which is also filled with the CSF. And the space between the arachnoid mater and the dura mater is referred as the subdural space. Okay, there also there is a presence of the CSF. So it is present in the both the positions. So options are given like between pia mater and arachnoid mater, that is one correct. Then between dura mater and cranium, no, there is no space is present. Okay, then between arachnoid and dura mater, yes, it is also correct. So here in this condition, both the answer, that is A and C, are correct. Okay, both the answer, that is A and C, are correct. Fine. The next, cerebrospinal fluid is secreted by, that is by the choroid plexus. Okay, that is secreted by the choroid plexus. Okay, so correct answer for question number 140 is the option number D. The next, 141, choroid plexus is a network of, okay, so choroid plexus is a network of, see, it is a network of nerves, capillaries, okay, muscle fibers, okay, and lymph vessels. So it is a network of muscle fibers basically. Here, yes, it is a network of muscle fibers. Fine. The next, 142, largest part of the human brain is, okay, largest part of the human brain is cerebrum. Fine. The next, 143, the black pigment in the eye which reduces internal reflection is located in, is located in the cornea. Okay, option B. The eye lens of the man is biconcave. That is option B. Protein found in the eye lens is collagen. Okay, that is yes, option B. The next, in the internal ear, the organ of Corti which bears hair cells is located in scala vestibuli. Okay, that is the scala vestibuli is the part where this hair cells are located. The next, in the circular ciliary muscles of eye are unable to contract, the okay lens will thin and stretched. So option C is correct for question number 147. The next, question number 148, anterior chamber of eye is the space between cornea and the iris. Okay, option B is correct for it. 149, aqueous and vitreous humor are divided by the optic nerve. Okay, it is divided by the optic nerve. So option D is correct for it. Space between cornea and lens is called vitreous chamber, is called vitreous chamber. So option C is correct for 150. Okay, then question number 151, that is retina is most sensitive at, okay, it is most sensitive at blind spot, that is option D. The next, the place in the eye of mammal from which optic nerve and blood vessels leaves the eyeball is, see, options are given, blind spot, fovea centralis, yellow spot, okay, and option D, none of these. So option D is correct for this. The next, 153, an area of the retina which does not have rods or cones is the red spot. Okay, option A is correct for it. The next, 154, in nocturnal birds the retina contains mostly, okay, nocturnal means those which are having the night vision. Okay, so basically they can have the rods basically, okay, and may also so have the cones but not developed, nocturnal in the sense night vision. Yes, they have the cones, sorry, option B will be correct over here, 154. Okay, the next, it is present in the rod cells and useful in night vision, that is rhodopsin. Okay, rhodopsin is a pigment which is present in the what, rod cells. Okay, the next, iodopsin is contained in the, okay, horizontal cells, option D. The next, 157, the central canal of the spinal cord is lined by epithelial tissue, that is option B. Which cranial nerve are purely sensory? Okay, so here option is given none of this. Okay, so a chart I have given to you of this, only three are the sensory neurons. Okay, just look after those chart. Fine. The next, which layer of the wall of an eyeball contains abundant blood vessels? Option A. Okay, that is the lens. See, many of the answers you might get differently here. Okay, see, don't get confused if find any difficulty, because surely some of the answers are mistaken over here in the answer key, and surely we'll try to solve it. Okay, when you have doubt, just text me the questions, we'll try to solve them again. Okay, the next, 160, in which part of the mammalian ear the nerve impulse of hearing starts? That is the cochlea, is the part. Okay, that is option B. 161, which of the following is known as cochlear duct? That is Kela tympani, is the option C. Then identify the correct sequence of the regions in the organization of human ear as an auditory mechanoreceptor organ. That is C, the options are, okay, pinna, auditory canal, then tympanum membrane, malleus, incus, stapes, cochlea, auditory nerve. So option A is the correct answer for question number 162. The next, question number 163, sound is amplified by, okay, so option B is given, that is the ear ossicle. Okay, the next, 164, in human ear which bone is connected with the tympanum? Okay, so here none of these is the correct answer. Okay, in the given options, that is option D. Then next, yes, anvil shaped bone is incus. Option A is correct for 165. 166, which of the following bone is in the direct contact with oval window? That is the option B, stapes. Then which of the following bone is in contact with the fenestra rotundus? That is option B, stapes. Then eustachian tube help to keep tympanum chamber moist. Of course, option B is correct. Okay, 169. In the ear of man, sound wave pass from middle to inner ear through, option A, foramen ovalis. The next, 170. Bony labrum contains a fluid called, that is a perilymph. Okay, that is option B. 171. Which of the following is an example of negative feedback loop in humans? So here option D is the correct for this, that is the constriction of skin, blood vessel and contraction of skeletal muscles when it is too cold. Okay, option D is correct for 171. Then 172, which part of the human ear plays no role in hearing as such, but is otherwise very much required? That is the vestibular apparatus. Okay, the next, in human human hindbrain comprises three parts, one of which is cerebellum. Okay, the next, a nerve impulse is generated when nerve cell undergoes depolarization. Okay, so when there is a depolarization, there will be a depolarization means due to action potential, depolarizing wave will be initiated. Okay, which will lead to the generation of a nerve impulse. Okay, so that is 174, option C. 175, cerebrospinal fluid is secreted by, that is the choroid plexus, as I told before. Then the capacity to differentiate colors lies in the, option A, cones. Okay, so this is about 176 question. Then next, question number 177. In the ear, membranous labyrinth is filled with fluid called endolymph. Option A. Okay, then next, 178. The region of the vertebrae eye, or the vertebrate eye, where optic nerve passes out of the retina and photoreceptor cell are not present in that region called blind spot. That is option C. The next question number 179, the specific receptors responsible for balance of the body and posture are, that is the crista and the macula, okay, are the answer for the question number 179. That is option B. The next, smallest bone in the body of human is, that is the option B, stapes. So student, this is about the entire paper discussion of biology, that is the class test on the neural control and coordination. See, certain question you may get difficulty in understanding in kind, if you feel any kind of difficulty, you can text me, okay. As well as few of the options have been changed, okay, as per as I have told you about it. Still, if you feel any of the multiple answers are correct or multiple options are correct, okay, just let me know, means we can discuss about it, okay. Thank you.